With the continual rise of AI, you would think that we need to train more engineers to prepare for what's to come. And I agree, yes, we need to. But when you look at the American engineering landscape, we see that about 50% of students drop out of engineering or change majors and leave when they get to college, right? We've seen that there's research that shows part of why this happens, and it goes back to how well are students prepared in the K-12 space. And we're seeing that some of that lack of preparation is why a lot of students drop out later on. My name is Amos Tarfa, Amos the Math Guy, and in this video, I'm gonna talk to you about a growing field of engineering, or a field that I think you need to look into. But before I do that, I wanna talk briefly about some other things I do. I teach math and science courses, I'm a medical physicist, and I also have an ACT course that prepares students for college. So if you're interested in taking the ACT, the SAT, or AP courses, reach out to amosthemathguy@gmail.com. But in this video, I wanna quickly remind you that I teach career planning for teens. I have courses or course materials for different fields of medicine and careers, and that this is the general landscape. So we do that on this channel. We provide you with the math tools that allow you to explore any field of study that you want to go into. But in this particular video, we're going to focus on engineering. We're going to talk about engineering, and then we're going to focus our efforts specifically to electrical engineering. So engineering, of course, has so many different branches. It has electrical, mechanical, there's aeronautical engineering, which is sort of connected to the mechanical engineering piece. And at Laterno University in Longview, Texas, they have a great program in mechanical engineering. This has some of the brochures that I got when I visited, and I'll be teaching in their math. As an adjunct teacher, I'll be teaching intermediate algebra. And so when you want to be an engineer, there's a few things you need. The first one, of course, is you need to have good organization skills. And so it'd be good to have, you know, sort of a time management resource like a calendar, a notebook, a planner. That's very good, right? Engineers need that. But next, we need to explore what are some good resources to help you become very good at engineering. Well, there's a book called Becoming an Engineer by Jake Ryland, and he talks about the average person's guide to getting good grades and succeeding in engineering school. This is a great resource if you're thinking of going into engineering. And so if you, let's say we know that you want to go into engineering, you've looked at books like Engineering for Teens, you know exactly what branch, what should you do to prepare for the future? I want to encourage you, before you prepare for the future, to find resources that talk about inventions and technology. And of course, I assume you've already watched some documentaries, you've seen some things, but make sure you're paying attention. Paying attention to the different challenges that have been solved by different innovators so that you can see how you can even make it better. Let's focus on electrical engineering. Electrical engineering deals with several different branches. There's computer and electrical engineering, there's engineering that is tied to the computer side, hardware, and then there's also electrical engineering that is focused more on the power and the grid. That's a different branch. There's telecoms engineering that you can look at as well. But the branch I want to look at specifically has to do with NVIDIA. I was listening to the CEO of NVIDIA, Jensen Huang. I've been inspired by just how he's willing to go above and beyond and think outside the box. And so in light of some of the challenges of, well, not challenges, but some of the growth in AI, it's important that you begin to explore what the technology has to do, like what is the technology, the technological framework. So even if you're in high school, be thinking about different things relating to AI, deep learning, large language models. Look into those things because that's part of where this is where we're headed, right? And so if you want to get ahead of the game, understand what's happening. Some of the research and some of the things that are happening right now, like some engineers haven't even learned some of this stuff, the current engineers, because we are just watching this explode. So I want to encourage you to pay attention to those things. Look up who Jensen Huang is with NVIDIA and pay attention to some of the things that he's telling you to look out and to look for. And so before I drop off this video, I want to encourage you to check out my course, my pre-algebra course or my Algebra 1, Algebra 2 course. If you want dual enrollment credit for Calculus 1, Calculus 2, pre-calculus, trigonometry, reach out to amosthemathguy@gmail.com. We have courses for you to help you have a solid engineering background. But maybe a parent is watching this and you have a youngster, maybe a fourth grader, fifth grader, sixth grader. I want to encourage you to have this resource called Understanding Mathematics from Counting to Calculus. You can email amosthemathguy@gmail.com and we'll get you a copy of this. But this is not expensive. It's about $25 and basically covers all the concepts, gives you an overview of all the concepts from basic counting all the way to calculus. If you want to be an engineer, you need to have a solid math base. This book was actually written by an electrical engineer, which is kind of cool. Electrical engineering is a wonderful field. I want to encourage students to look out for it. In my series of discussions on careers, I'm going to cover every branch in the STEM field for sure. I want people to be aware of what's out there in the STEM field. And so take your notebook and just keep taking notes on the different fields that we discuss. We have a course on ACT, SAT prep, and we integrated it with career prep because we want our students to know exactly what they want to do with their lives. We don't just want you to get a perfect score on the SAT. We need you to know what you're going to do with it, right? So that's the important part of what makes our course different. So lastly, before I leave, we're talking about electrical engineering and the changing times. And I think it would be good to have to step back and have a philosophical discussion about how should we handle technology. And so this is called 2084 by Professor John Lennox, Artificial Intelligence and the Future of Humanity. He talks about Rosalind Picard in the book as well. Rosalind Picard is a professor at MIT in computer science. And so it's interesting when you can look at the discussions about the metaphysical implications of our discoveries, or let's not call it that. Let's say the implications of the things we are seeing and discovering, right? The ethics. Is it okay to do everything? Just because we can do it, is it okay to use the technology for this, that, and the other? Science can give us certain tools, but we need a framework that can help us think about whether the use of those things can go wrong in certain areas. Think about those issues, especially this summer, 2084. You can reach out to our bookstore if you want a copy, 2084 by Dr. John Lennox. So my name is Amos Tarfa again. I hope that you continue to follow me in my journey as I teach the history and the history and the context of subjects and the career preparation materials, because I want to raise the next generation of scientists, mathematicians, and thinkers who also know the history and philosophy of science, logic, and theology. So reach out if you have any questions. Thank you for watching this video, and stay tuned for our next video in the series of career prep and college preparation for students. Take care and have a blessed day.